Hi, I'm AJ.
Hi, I'm Justin.
Hi, I'm Jessamine.
Hi, I'm Paolo.
Hi, I'm Leah.
And together we're
the sassy,
the smart,
the sweet,
the swanky,
the spirited,
the fantastic,
and the, wait, what?
I think you should go with the silly.
The silly!
And the sensational
seven!
We just love the number seven.
Well, yes, seven is a significant number. In math, seven is considered to be a lucky prime number. There are seven colors in the rainbow, seven continents, and the seven seas. Arr!
It is the number of music notes in a scale. It is also the number of spots most commonly found on ladybugs.
There are seven elements of art. It is the number of completeness in the Bible.
Oh yes, just like the 7 days of creation.
In today's episode, we'll be learning with you about these interesting sevens, the seven elements of art, and the 7 days in which God, the original and greatest artist, created the whole world.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Dark blue. I like pastel blue, like the sky. Colors have different shades or value. Value in art is the quality of light and dark of a certain shade or tone.
Then
about value.
In the beginning, God created light and separated it from dark. Now, close your eyes and think of the darkest dark.
Making me a little dizzy. But do you know what it reminds me of?
A fly that you can't catch?
No, it reminds me of a line. It is the most basic element of art. It is also known as a moving da.
Oh yes, that's right. In dance, it is the outline of a dancer's complete body while performing steps or poses.
Move with me.
It is the phrase or the complete thought that runs through a composition. Listen to this line.
In theater, a line is what actors say in a performance.
In visual arts, line is used to define and emphasize elements and space. God used the line to make the silver lining that separates the sea and the sky. See the line where the sky meets the sea, it calls me.
No, I don't think we're doing that right now. We did that 3 years ago.
Yeah!
That sounds really nice. Mind if I add texture to it?
I know all about texture. It's itchy as a rash or as scratchy as sand. Thick and fully rough, I feel my sticky.
No, I actually meant something different. Why don't you play that melody again?
That sounds nice, but don't you mean accompaniment, not texture?
Yes, I meant both. By adding chords to your melody, I'm adding texture to your music.
Oh, cool. Hey, Pat, come jam with us and add even more texture.
Sure.
I feel my sticky gooey hands. Can you found strands of spaghetti? There's a sound making beautiful harmony.
On the surface, in space, or on the ground, these are textures, textures all around. On the
When God separated the waters from the land, He put a lot of texture on dry ground by creating different landforms and filling them up with plants, trees, and flowers of all kinds.
Walked among the shadows, you wiped my tears away, and I felt the pain of heartbreak, and I've seen the brighter days, and I pray prayers to heaven from my lowest place, and I have held your blessings, God, you give and take away. No matter what I have, your grace is enough. No matter where on the mountains, I will bow my life to the one who sent me there. On the valley, I will lift my eyes to the one who sees me there.
Standing on the mountain, I didn't get there on my own. When I'm walking through the valley, I know I am not alone.
Your God of the hills and valleys, hills and valleys, God of the hills.
My dreams get broken, in you I hope again. No matter what, I know I'm safe inside your hands.
On the mountains, I will bow my life to the one who sent me there. In the valley, I will lift my eyes to the one who sees me there. When I'm standing on the mountain, I didn't get there on my own. When I'm walking through the valley,
I just made something unexpected. Something sharp, something new. It's not symmetrical or perfect, but it's beautiful and it's mine. What else can I do?
Bring it in, bring it in. Guitar.
What else
bring
can
it
I do?
Just random splashes of glitter, though. The night sky is the best example of using negative space to highlight positive space in visual arts. Because of the darkness, your eyes can focus on constellations.
In space, we move around. There's your space, and here's mine. But there's a special space. God made by design.
4, 3, 2, 1.
This star is the bull over there. And Orion the hunter over there.
Oh yeah, I see what you mean. Look over there. I see a toothbrush, a jellyfish, and I think I see a robot over there.
I'm not sure it works that way.
Look, there's a red star over there.
Oh, that one is actually Mars, the red planet.
How can we tell which ones are planets and which ones are stars?
Well, the stars are the ones that twinkle. Their lights appear to be blinking.
I wonder why all those stars and planets were put so far away from us, in space.
God put the sun, moon, stars, and planets there to mark the seasons like winter, spring, summer, and fall. He also gave them a sign for mankind to watch out for. In fact, there is one special star on one special night that pointed to one very special baby.
universe and I. In the night I lie, I look up at you. When the morning comes, I watch your eyes. It's a paradise they couldn't capture, that bright infinity inside your eyes.
I fly to you every night, forgetting that it is just a dream. I met you with a smile, never and forever, baby.
You are my universe, and I just want to put you first.
Dark in the shadows that grew long, and they said that we can't be together
because we come from different sides. And
today, we're going to use shapes to make a menagerie of different animals created on the fifth day of creation. Would you like to help us imagine what shapes can be used to form different creatures of the sea and the sky? Let's see. Here's a picture of a bird. Can you tell me what shapes you can see in its form?
What can we use to make this picture? Forms can be made with different shapes. Circles and diamonds, squares, some rectangles. Figures are made out of shapes. Triangles, hearts, ovals, and pentagons. Look what we made out of shapes.
Its head is round like a circle. Its body, an oval. Its beak and wings are shaped like triangles. That's it! We made a bird!
How about we make a sea creature? Like this fish. Let's see. Its body is an oval, its fins and tail are triangles, and its scales are crescent shaped. Wonderfully, God made use of shapes to form the many different types of creatures of the skies and seas.
to swallow every chickadee, every little bird in the tall oak tree, the wide old owl and the big black crow, flapping them wings, singing go bird, go
rock and robin, rock, rock.
In the treetops all day long, hopping and a bopping and a singing a song. All the little birdies on Jaybird Street love to hear the robin go tweet, tweet, tweet.
Rock, 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 rock.
Objects from nature, animals, and people. People's forms are defined by their physical features. And speaking of physical features, have you ever looked in the mirror and wished your eyes could be wider or your nose could look a little sharper? Well, let me assure you that when God made man on the sixth day, He made sure that we were fearfully and wonderfully made and that each form and feature was put there for a purpose.
After all, we are made in His image and likeness. Let us tell you a story about a boy
who wanted to be rid of one distinct feature of his. Magnificent Benito and His Two Front Teeth, adapted from the story written by Augie Rivera and Mike Rivera.
There was once a boy born with a full set of teeth. People said that the village midwife and all who saw his toothy grin burst out laughing. Their laughter resounded all over the sleepy town of San Cristobal.
Would you look at the size of those teeth?
Just looking at his teeth, his two front teeth, never seen anything like them. Looking at his teeth, his two front teeth, we can't keep ourselves from laughing.
Nobody wanted to adopt the poor boy. Luckily, Sister Margarita of the Periwinkle Sisters took him in. He was named Benito, after the kind Mother Superior's great-grandfather, who had a big toothy smile because his dentures were too big for his butt. At the monastery, Benito grew up helping the nuns tend to their giant turnip plantation.
Here, Benito. Come here, a little closer. Help me till the soil.
Yes, Sister Margarita.
Don't forget to tend to those giant turnips.
Wow, I've never seen turnips this big and beautiful.
Benito's two front teeth reached about 6 inches long and were as wide as his spatula. Worse, they stuck out like an elephant's tusks. Because of this, Benito kept to himself, spent most of his time munching on turnips, and never made any friends.
Okay, say ah.
Ah. Ah, ah. Can't you just pull them out?
Sorry, your two front teeth are just too strong. I might hurt you if I have to pull them out.
Oh, how I wish I didn't have these big ugly front teeth.
Soon, Benito was old enough to leave the monastery. He hopped from one job to another because his front teeth would always get in the way. People around him just could not stop laughing at his gigantic front teeth. His big, ugly front teeth brought him nothing but grief and humiliation. Everywhere he went, people laughed at him and called him cruel names. Oh, how he wished he didn't have those big, ugly front teeth.
Just looking at his teeth, his two front teeth, never seen anything like them. Looking at his teeth, his two front teeth, we can't keep ourselves from laughing.
Moon hung in the sky like a half-bitten cookie when Benito was visited by the Tooth Fairy in his sleep.
I just wanna apologize for giving you those big, ugly front teeth.
Well, can't you just pull them out?
Unfortunately, I just give teeth. I don't pull them out.
You have to go to the dentist for that.
But I've been to all the dentists in town. None of them can pull out my big, ugly front teeth.
Unfortunately, what you have are already permanent. I'll be retiring soon, too.
No one believes in tooth fairies anymore.
Ta-ta.
Your dream's getting too long.
No.
Then the tooth fairy vanished from the dream. Benito woke up, greatly upset by his dream.
If no one can help me pull out these big ugly front teeth, I'll have to pull them out myself.
Immediately, he went to Aling Chayong Sari-Sari store and bought boxes of pasillas de leche, a bag of yama balls, bottles of strawberry jam, and carloads of candy. For a week, he ate nothing but sweets, hoping to get the most vicious tooth decay. But his teeth did not even ache. His stomach did. Undaunted, he came up with another idea. He got himself the strongest abaca rope, tied one end to his front teeth and the other to a nara tree. Then, he ran as fast as he could, hoping the rope would pull his teeth out. But to his dismay, his front teeth did not even come off. Instead, the tree was uprooted.
Still, Benito did not give up. He thought of the most brilliant plan. At the nearest train station, he strapped himself to a cement post. He tied one end of the rope to his teeth. For 3 days and three nights, he waited for a train to pass. When it came, he lassoed the other end of the rope to the passing train.
Finally, I will rid myself of these big ugly front teeth!
The train wiggled and jiggled, screeched to a stop, then turned turtle 3.5 times. What a catastrophe! Luckily for the train passengers, they all survived the disaster. As for the ill-fated Benito, his big ugly front teeth survived too!
No!
Benito, feeling downhearted, sought comfort among the gigantic turnips of the good nuns. There, he munched on a turnip as he contemplated on a seemingly luckless life. Suddenly, he noticed something unusual. He had unconsciously crafted the turnip into the figure of a swan. He was so amazed that his big, ugly front teeth could create such a beautiful thing.
Benito, this is magnificent!
Benito then realized a magnificent way to put his teeth to good use. He created the most fascinating sculptures. Flowers out of fruits, animals out of vegetables, human figures out of ice, and even churches out of wood. Soon, he put up Benito's teeth-crafted treasures and became famous all over the world for the tasteful and exquisite quality of his works.
Benito, these are magnificent!
For the first time since he was born, Benito smiled his wide, toothy grin. People say that up to now, Benito's shop still stands proud and is regarded as a landmark in San Cristobal. Well, I can't tell you more because that's all I know of Benito's story. But what I do know is that he'll be long remembered for more than just his big, ugly front teeth.
Just looking at his teeth, his two front teeth, and looking at his creations, just look how they form so wonderfully made. Benito, the magnificent Benito, he loved the two front teeth, oh, he meant to be that way.
One, two, three, four, five, six. Wow, we are now down to our last element of art, which is color, and the seventh day of creation.
God actually finished his creation in 6 days. On the seventh day, he rested.
God has a special relationship with his creation. During the time of Noah, after the flood, he made a covenant with all of his creation. It was a promise to never again destroy the human race and all animals with flood waters.
And as a sign he would keep his promise, he put a rainbow in the sky.
Colors begin.
What's that voice you hear? Color makes it.
God used his colors to reassure us that he keeps his promises and reassure that he's kept his ultimate promise to preserve our lives because he has sent us, his only begotten Son, our Messiah, to save us from sin and death.
So, whenever you see a rainbow in the sky, remember that
God keeps his promises!
People wrote in 2A, take 1.
Ready!
We're not gonna do this like a play, so it's not chronological. We'll be seeing. You guys know your lines, like if I say like scene two. Alright, good luck to that big leg.
Ha ha ha!